As you are getting closer to completing your final projects, some of you have come to me and asked if there's a way to add physics within your scenes. Now, there are many ways of creating physics solvers in Maya. They include things such as M particles and cloth and hair. There's constraints, obviously, field solvers, and there are others such as mesh and bullet that actually need to be activated. So for example, to add bullet onto your scene, onto your menu, you need to go to the Windows drop-down menu, setting preferences, plugin manager. And in the window for plugin manager, you need to make sure that you activate that under bullet. There it is. So you need to make sure that both of these are checked so that we can go ahead and make sure that we have access to that menu for the solvers that this provides to us. So in this particular video, I am going to be showing you how to use fields and solvers. And for that, what we want to do is I want to go ahead and create a couple of gears. So to do so, notice that I am under the effects menu, but I still have access to my create dropdown. So I'm going to go to create and I am going to polygon primitives. Let's create gears. So the goal for this video is to make a gear that controls another gear. So I'm going to rotate this 90 degrees. I want to make this gear drive another gear. So let's go ahead and make a copy of this gear to the right of it. Let me rotate this, all right, and let's get closer to it. Now I want to make sure that they are aligned in such a way that one can move the other. So my goal will be to make this gear, the one that I have selected right now, rotate 360 degrees clockwise and make this gear rotate in the opposite direction. That is the goal of the exercise. So with that done, let's go ahead and select this gear, the one that I want to make the driver. And I want to add some keyframes to it. So when I press Shift E on the keyboard, my time marker is on the first frame. So I want to make sure that I add some rotation values. Before I do that, actually, let me undo that. Let me freeze my transformations for that gear so that everything is at zero. So let's go ahead and press Shift E to create the rotation keyframes. Go to about 120 frames in my case, and I am going to rotate this about, say, 360 degrees, negative 360 degrees on the x-axis. So what that's going to do is going to create the animation, as you can see, and it has, as you notice on the playback, it has ECs in and ECs out. So I need to fix that on my graphing editor in a few. So with this done, what I want to do now that the animation has been added to this, I want to go ahead and set that. I want to make this its rigid body that will make this one react when it interacts with it. So I want to go ahead and select that geometry, go to field solvers, and I want to go to create passive rigid body. Now, what that does to this is basically it tells it if anything hits you, nothing happens to you. But if you hit something, whatever you hit will be moving. So in this case, this is what will be hitting this gear, and it will. This gear and will start rotating once this one hits it. So with that done, if I play this back, really nothing happens because the other object has not been tagged to be anything. So let's select that other gear, go under the fuel solvers, and instead of using a passive body, this time I'm going to use an active rigid body. So what that does, it basically tags this to react to the passive rigid body. So this one hits, this one will react. When I do that, let me go ahead and hit playback. You'll notice that as soon as it hits it, this thing starts flying away, this other gear. And the reason for that is because this is the active gear. This is the one that will react. So I want to keep it in place. And to do so, I want to go ahead and use a constraint. So the constraint I'm going to use on this is a hinge constraint. Now let's take a look at this really quick and go under field solvers. Create hinge constraint. Now you notice that there are several options for constraints. So you have nail constraints, pin constraints, and so on. In this case, we want to use a hinge because we want that to be actually acting like the pivot, like the rotating pivot for that particular gear. So I'm going to use hinge constraint options. And in this case, I want to go ahead and reset this to its original settings. Make sure that I have hinge under the constraint type. And I want to make sure that noticing that this is set up the way it is, if I set up my hinge the way that with the values that I have right now, my hinge would be in this direction. It would be going in the Z axis, flat on the X axis. And that's not what I want. I want this to be flat on the X axis. Yes, but flat on the Y axis as well. I don't want it to be projected on the Z axis. So that means I need to rotate this on the y-axis. You'll notice that the y-axis is pointing up on my worldview. So I need to make sure that I rotate it 90 degrees on the y-axis. That way, when it rotates, it basically, it goes flat in this direction towards the x-axis. And when I click apply or create, you'll notice that I create a solver, a constraint right there. That is, it's like a little tube. This one render, by the way, that's just a constraint, and it's constraining the position of that object, but it allows it to rotate around that particular projection. So if I close this really quick, you'll notice that when I play this back, the two gears interact, and the second one is animated based on the rotation of the first.